Alright, what's happening? As you can clearly tell, it's windy, so we had. If it's hard for you to hear me, sorry about that. Welcome back to the football discussion. Today's video is reviewing the three Friday Premier League games. I predicted Sheffield United and Manchester City for the first game. I said 3-0 Man City, I was 1-0 Man City. So I basically got the kind of result that I just thought the score line predicted how to win with it. Because it didn't. That's what happened. It was a great strike from Kyle Walker against his boyhood club, which is unfortunate for Aaron Ramsdale on goal to not keep it out, but those things happen. For the overall game, it was weird because you would have expected City to score more with them, more chances they had, but they couldn't. Loudstrom for Sheffield United did have a very good chance to make it one each, closer to time, but couldn't take it. City did dominate from start to finish, didn't really give away many chances for Sheffield United, apart from one that was could have been killer for them in the title race. Obviously, this game was a highlights game, so I'm only going off that. To be honest, City, with Pep, as is now, was rumoured that Pep would join Barcelona again, but he's came out and said he won't. Good on him. Personally, will Pep go back? I think so. I don't think he'll stay at City for long, maybe another season or two. Because he doesn't really spend too long at teams. For me personally, the City result was a fully deserved result for City. Sheffield United probably should have scored and took something from the game, but those are the margins of football you need to get away. You can't get away with. You don't score, you don't have a chance, as Mike Lowen would say. Second match is Chelsea against Burnley. I predicted a 2-1 win for Chelsea. It was a 3-0 win for Chelsea. All three goals for Chelsea were very good moves. The Ziyech strike was a good hit. He was played in and he's hit the ball across Nick Pope. Nick Pope couldn't really react and dive the way he came from. The goal from Zuma was a very good ball in from Mason Mount. Very good powerful header. The goal from Werner was a very good move from Chelsea themselves. Timo Werner doing what Timo Werner was doing last season and has currently been doing, scoring goals. He'll definitely be up there in the Golden Boot race, probably will win it, which wouldn't surprise me if he does. As he'll be he will be crucial in a good season for Chelsea. If he's doing what he done for RB Leipzig last season, he is going to win the. He's got well not win the golden, not just win the golden, but help Chelsea in the title race. As the same as the Man City result, Chelsea dominated from start to finish. I think they actually restricted Burnley to no shots on target, which is impressive. They coped with their physicality very well, which was a surprise. As Chelsea's defence has been very, very vulnerable, but last three Premier League games, three clean sheets. That Edouard Mendy equals a record with Peter Cech, I think every single clean sheet he gets to the now. So it is good from him, he is definitely a good goalkeeper. But I'm not here to comment on the goalkeeper, I'm here to comment on the team. Chelsea played well, definitely deserved the 3 points. Burnley didn't deserve anything from the match, not even a point. But that, I'll move into the final game, which was Liverpool-West Ham, which I predicted 3-1 Liverpool, and it was 2-1 Liverpool. So extremely close. Those were half as nut in the background, brilliant. Overall, watching the game back, it was very poor defending from Joe Gomez not to header clear the cross from Masuaku. thought I was bringing down, had a strike at it, and I was also very, very poor from Joe, from Alison Becker in goal. He should really be saving that. It's straight at him, there's no excuses. That's his fault. The penalty for Salah, for Liverpool to equalise, it was a penalty, but Salah just made it look like he got shot. That's the way that Salah done that pen, that's the way he does his, all of his reactions to penalties. That's why people call him a diving cheat, which you do get, because some of the penalties he's been given are not penalties. But you ultimately just need to go with it. It was a penalty and it was deserved. Diego Jota's goal to make it 2-1 in the 17th minute was chopped off, which I don't think it should have been. Looking back, maybe it was a foul on Fabianski, but at the same time, I can't really see how that was stopping Fabianski if he was reaching the ball anyway. Diego Jota did make it 2-1 7 minutes later, with 5 minutes before time, for a good ball for Shaqiri. Split through the West Ham defence, into the bottom corner for 2-1 Liverpool to put them currently top of the Premier League again. Jurgen Klopp will be buzzing. It won't be an easy feat now to keep that up, but ultimately it needs to happen. Liverpool do need to keep it up if they want to go back to back for the first time in decades. That'll happen in today's video. Obviously these are a bit shorter, just as I'm trying out something new. Like the video if you haven't already, subscribe to the channel, follow the Twitter account, and with that, hope you have had a good weekend. Catch us all on Friday for the next episode. With that, catch us all later. Peace. See ya.